Oh, hello there. I'm Nemo.
Oh! Hi, Nemo.
Nick, you need to be careful. He's coming for you.
Who are you talking about?
The heterosexist with outdated beliefs and inappropriate attitudes.
Ugh. Let me take care of this guy.
Nick, violence is not the answer. You won't defeat him with that.
What's the answer then?
Well, I know it sounds a bit cliche, but... love.
You really think that would work?
Mm-hmm. Oh, no. You don't have to make love to anybody. You know, just like a metaphor, the power of love, friendship, kindness, and of course, well-founded argumentation. You know?
Okay, all right, yeah, let's do this. I'll put this away. You guys are ridiculous. I don't care what you think, I'm gonna say it anyway. Homosexuality is a choice. What are you laughing about? You okay?
Yeah, sorry. Can you just imagine this guy that's waking up in the morning and he's like, I've been straight all my life, but from now on, it's gay time. Of course you do not choose to be homosexual, like you don't choose to be asexual, bi, pan, or heterosexual. It's very likely that you are already born with a sexual orientation predisposition, and this attraction towards a certain category of people will be apparent, will start being apparent during your puberty. And your sexual orientation is not the result of a magic trick. Yeah, McKellen, Josh Takei, now your baby's gay. You do not choose to be attracted to a category of people. I mean, if you had the option, would you choose a sexual orientation that is still super stigmatized and for which the suicide rate is significantly higher? People don't choose to be the way they are, they just are. The only choices that those who do not conform to the outdated norms of society have are to repress or accept their identity orientation, to hide it or to come out. And you would agree with me that these options showcase a deeper and fundamental problem.
Huh. All right, well maybe you don't choose it then, but homosexuality is still clearly a societal deviance, like video games and tattoos. I got an eye on the suspect. The deviant seems very dangerous.
I'm attracted to people of the same sex.
We need backup! Move!
No, homosexuality has always existed in all human cultures and in all points in time. There's nothing modern and there's nothing deviant about homosexuality.
Okay, but there are clearly cultures with more gays than others.
Good try, but no. It's true that every culture has its own level of tolerance vis-a-vis homosexuality. For example, some countries are more tolerant and even favor adolescent male homosexuality. But guess what? The percentage of homosexual is not higher in this society. That is because sexual behavior is not the same as sexual orientation.
Well, I know what I see with my own eyes, and clearly there are more homosexuals today than before.
Well, the distribution of homosexuality in the population has not changed over time. It's just that, you know, the world today is becoming slowly a better place for the queer community. I mean, in the 18th century, male homosexuality was subject to the death penalty in the original 13 American colonies. 150 years ago, in England, you could still be hanged for homosexual activity. And in World War II Germany, they were persecuted and imprisoned in concentration camps. And I'm not saying that today's world is perfect, but there has been a lot of improvement in terms of LGBT communities' rights. So of course, most of them used to hide or repress their orientation.
Whatever. Homosexuality is unnatural, though. How about that?
Mother Nature?
Yes, my child.
Hi, hello. So I have to classify a few things from Earth, but I'm not sure if for some of those I should use the natural stamp or the demonic one.
Natural refers to any element of the physical universe, including matter, forces, and energy. Earth, humans, human society, and the products of that society are all natural.
Uh-huh. So, poop?
Poop is natural.
Toothbrush?
Natural.
Satellites?
Natural.
Gays? Okay, gotcha. What about stupidity, cruelty, and genocide?
Oh, totally natural.
Well, the semantics of what is natural or not is a debate itself. You should define what you consider natural first. If you think that by being homosexual, we are willingly breaking the laws of nature that want us to be attracted to the opposite sex, firstly, you are oversimplifying and fundamentally misunderstanding how complex nature is. And secondly, you are sacralizing your misconception. So, if by natural you mean biological, we have collected some clues over the years. Evidence of a correlation between the action of sexual hormones during the prenatal phase, development of certain regions of the brain, and sexual orientation. We also do see a lot of homosexual behavior in other animals. The studies do not offer a definitive and absolute explanation to our orientation, but they clearly suggest a biological component that is very likely to be there. You know, the cause underlying the determination of our sexual orientation is probably multifactorial though, and very complex, and it's still very mysterious. It's also a topic that is ethically very complicated to study, but arbitrarily denying the natural property, whatever that means, of any sexual orientation just doesn't make sense. And it's not even an argument. Whether it's biological, cultural, or a bit of both, whether we are the only animals showing true homosexual orientation or not, it just doesn't matter.
You know, you're really making my brain hurt. So you're saying it's natural, but we don't know exactly why?
Well, it's natural depending on your definition of natural. So, unless your definition itself is explicitly excluding homosexuality, there is no reason why the definition of natural would only fit certain type of sexual orientation and not others. And of course, we don't know exactly why, and that's okay, that is fine, because, you know, we don't need to know every little detail acting on the determination of our own nature in order to accept who we are. If you think that heterosexuality is natural, well, homosexuality and any other orientation must also be natural.
Huh, funny. So what do we do? Just accept everything that's natural?
No. That is really not what I'm saying. There are a lot of natural things that humans do that are terrible, that hurt people and other living beings, but you cannot compare those things to the harmless and beautiful act of loving someone of the same sex.
Yeah, right! So maybe it's natural, but homosexuality is probably a genetic anomaly, like a mutation or something like that.
You know, first of all, genetic mutation is something that is constantly happening in our bodies. They are one of the driving factors of evolution. And without them, we would not be here. And by definition, we are all mutants. And sure, it's very likely that, like the color of your eyes or any other biological trait, your sexual orientation has some form of genetic basis. There are actually some studies exploring the question, and even if we found the one gene of homosexuality, which is never gonna be the case, this does not give it a negative connotation.
Wait. Homosexuality is dangerous because if we don't reproduce as a species, We're done. You want to go extinct? I don't want to go extinct.
Well, in Western society, we have evidence of homosexuality since at least ancient Greece. And look where we are now. So unless we all become gay from one day to another, not today. We are really far from extinction.
This guy is debunking everything I'm saying. Maybe I should just say the complete opposite. Homosexuality is dangerous because they want to reproduce. They want to pollute the minds of others and conquer the world.
Sexual orientation is not contagious. Ideas, good and bad, are though. The orientation of your parents is not going to determine your own orientation. It's the public disclosure and recognition of homosexuality that is highly influenced by the family, the social context, and the willingness of the individual. So, if your concern is that children adopted by gay couples will automatically turn gay, well, that's not how it works. But of course, if the parents are gay, it will be easier for them to be open about it. Also, you know what? The LGBT community is not a conspiracy. They're not trying to conquer the world. Right, Nick? Nick?
I don't know what you're talking. I'm fine.
And you know what? I understand. I mean, I don't agree with your points, but I understand that it's hard to accept new notions and values that were not deeply present in the mentality of your generation or of your culture. But we are evolving creatures, constantly trying to understand who we are, and we don't get the definitive answer to that question from one day to another. We have to go step by step, and you need to catch up with that, because it is our moral duty to make this place a better world for everybody.
I give up.
Do you know this interview?
We bring in the studio this morning one of the gay rights activists, Mr. Should I call you Mr.? Sure. Pepe Julian Onzima. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you for
good morning.
Me. Morning to you.
Why are you gay?
Why are you homosexual? Like, why are you asexual? Why are you pansexual? Why are you bisexual? Why are you heterosexual?
This might be one of the dumbest and yet deepest questions you could ask someone. Simply because you're essentially asking someone, why are you you? And why are we the way we are is a fundamental question that is worth being asked. But it has to be done in a smart and sensitive way.
And when done properly, we can acquire knowledge about ourselves that can be used for good. Some people do use pseudoscientific reasoning in order to justify their negative attitudes towards the queer community. So well-founded scientific arguments can help in debunking those false ideas and maybe even change their minds. For example, the statement that there are only two genders because there are only two biological sexes, it doesn't work, because in science we do acknowledge the multidimensionality of human sexuality.
Sexual behavior, orientation, identity, and role are not the same thing. They are sometimes correlated, but not necessarily, to genetic, gonadal, and anatomical sex, which are also not the same thing.
Knowledge about our identity and sexuality also allows us to develop concrete tools to help those who suffer from psychological discomfort and distress, like gender dysphoria, for example.
It also helps us spread the idea that our sexual orientation is a natural part of us and not some cultural deviance. Statistics clearly show that people are starting to accept this reality, and that's great. It's beautiful.
But I think that my final point, and maybe the most important thing I want to say today, is that, you know, in the end, you don't need any explanation or justification to be who you are. More important than why are we the way we are is why are we? And why are we if not to seek happiness and love each other?
Be proud of who you are. It doesn't matter if it's biological or magical.
Be proud of who you love. It doesn't matter which hormone or which area of your brain is involved. Science is cool, guys. But love, well, love is cooler, and the rest doesn't matter that much. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video, and happy Pride.
Happy Pride.
Hey, I want to thank Nick from SoundlyAwake. Collaborating with you on this video has been so much fun and super cool, and I cannot wait to do that again. If you are not subscribed to his channel, maybe you should. He talks about geography and languages and culture in general. He does a lot of blogging and he's super fun. Go check it out, the link is in the description. If you like what I do on my channel and you would like to help a little bit, I also have a Patreon, so the link is also in the description. It's a very nice way of supporting my work just for a few bucks a month, the price of a coffee essentially. And if you wanna hang out with me and the community, we also have a Discord server. The link is in the description. You should come there. We should hang out together, spend some time, know each other. I like that. Yeah? So maybe I'll see you there. Bye!